So this guy's like an anime celebrity.
I guess so.
I don't want to do this show anymore. Welcome to Waifu Wars. I'm your host, Asterios Kokonos. On my right, my co-host, Serancho.
Hi there.
On my left, special guest star, anime expert, Mumkey Jones. Say hi.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Waifu Wars.
Now, Mumkey Jones is famous on the internet for wearing this monkey mask right here and talking about anime. And by talking about anime, I mean not talking about anime. Some of your favorite animes include Two Broke Girls.
Two Broke Girls, Cory in the House.
Mm-hmm. King of the Hill.
Mm-hmm. Just all the anime classics. Studio Ghibli has been very busy the last decade.
Oh my God.
I think their greatest creation, Cory in the House,
oh,
really.
Of course. They predicted Obama's presidency. Mm-hmm. They did like a black man in the White House. Who would have thought?
I like their Cory classics. The Seinfeld. I think nothing can really hold a
right?
candle to their
you
classic
did an
Seinfeld.
Anime review of Seinfeld. Didn't you do an anime review of fucking Friends and Seinfeld?
I've done so many things I can't even remember.
God damn it, Mumkey Jones.
Japan, they're full of crazy ideas and they just turn it all into anime.
Right, like a woman in a corporate working world.
Yeah,
insane.
Like a woman who's respected. Like, who would have ever thought of that idea before?
Total fantasy and I love
Japanese
it.
Japanese is crazy.
I disagree with you both, but I'm willing to move on. Okay, so now, Mumkey Jones, what is it about anime that like got you so interested? Like, what was your first anime experience?
Well, as most anime fans can attest, in middle and high school, I did not have any friends. Mm-hmm. So anime was a source of friendship for me. You know, my best friends in middle school, Yugi Moto, Seto Kaiba, Joey Wheeler. You need friends, and anime is how you get them.
Wow, so, I really hate the fucking fact that I know exactly who all of those
names
are.
What did he just say? What are those names?
He's naming characters from Yu-Gi-Oh!
Really?
The yes. original friend simulator before Red Letter Media came out. Right. You had to go to your Yu-Gi-Ohs, your Pokemons. Like, these animes made you feel like you weren't a social outcast, even though they ensured that you were.
Okay. See, I'm familiar with, like, Brock, Misty,
of course.
Ash.
Yeah.
When I watched Yu-Gi-Oh, I got the sense that this was shittier, worse Pokemon. Is that correct or incorrect?
Well, I mean, you got dogfighting with Pokemon, mm-hmm. and then with Yu-Gi-Oh, it's a children's card game. So it's PETA would probably enjoy Yu-Gi-Oh more. Mm-hmm. Are you a big PETA guy?
I like it when they make the ladies naked and they're like, I would never wear fur. I'm totally nude. And it's like, okay, A, almost no one's wearing fur now. I don't know who's wearing, like, Joan Rivers was the last person to wear fur.
She's
and
she's been dead for 8 years.
Yeah, she's been fucking dead for 8 years.
You gotta go, like, out of your way to find fur.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, whenever I see those ads, it's like, okay, I get it. You don't eat. Congratulations on not eating.
So I think it goes without saying, if you're a big PETA fan, you're also a big Yu-Gi-Oh fan. They go hand in hand because there's okay. no dog fighting.
All right.
Yeah. So you're a Yu-Gi-Oh fan, you didn't even know it.
I guess I love Yu-Gi-Oh. Oh, yeah. I love the game Yu-Gi-Oh.
Just look at the camera and say, you know, Dark Magician is my
yeah,
boy.
Yeah, Dark Magician girl, big boobs.
Oh, skimpy yeah, that's a good waifu.
What's the other one in the clamshell? The girl that opens the clamshell and shoots
ooh, like
arrows.
Archer Lady, I think
yeah,
is her name.
Yeah, Clam Archer Lady. I don't remember. There was a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh characters.
You both look so normal. Like, here's the interesting thing to me. You're both, like, traditionally attractive people, and yet you know a lot of... You can go pretty deep on Yu-Gi-Oh.
I like to say that I had the autism beat out of me in middle school.
Okay.
Yeah, see, Monkey...
I'm listening.
Monkey, this is something that you don't know, but Asterios does, but all the fans out there don't. See, I would have been into anime since I was in middle school, and I used to be out about it until about eighth grade.
You're a closet anime fan.
I was a closet anime fan from ninth grade to 12th grade, where I joined cheerleading and became the bully that I was bullied by. But now I'm out and proud.
See, as an anime fan, just the word cheerleader triggers me so much. And I just want to actively hate you and post death threats on your social media right
now. You should.
Because you used to be a cheerleader.
Yes, you should.
Because as all anime fans know, cheerleaders are scum of the earth. Stacy's
3DPDs, as we like to call them.
You would Chad's everywhere.
You would both of you would do so well on, like, Tinder. And yet, you're both so obsessed with these weird Japanese cartoons where they'll literally take any excuse to have a lady's clothes fly off. I've been watching this one show, Food Wars. Because Sriracha is making me. And these people eat food, and when the food is delicious, their clothes explode off their bodies. Mumkey Jones, as an anime expert,
yeah.
Is this a normal thing for anime?
Oh, of course. If there's an anime where a woman's clothes don't burst off of her, it might as well be a Western cartoon.
Going straight in the trash
might
can.
Might as well be watching Avatar The Last Airbender if her clothes aren't blowing off at every given opportunity. I mean, the whole point of anime is to masturbate to a children's cartoon.
Right. I would be reading a book if I didn't want to see
I'd be reading a manga at that point. Because then you can't see the animated version of the clothes coming off.
How are you supposed to sell expensive uncensored Blu-rays if you don't have boobs flying all over?
Yeah. The thing that interests me about anime, and the reason that I continue to do this series, is that there is this odd dichotomy that you anime fans have. Where on one hand, you seem to be ironic about your love for these cartoons. You're just like, oh, ha, 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 Japanese booby cartoons. I know it's bad. But then on the other hand, you spend hundreds of dollars and thousands of hours watching these cartoons. Is it ironic or is it real?
It's real covered. Okay, so you know how you got M&M's and sometimes they have peanuts inside.
Yeah.
The peanut is the real and the chocolate coating and the shell is the irony and we use it to protect ourselves.
I've just got to say the line between irony and sincerity has blurred so much in the last 2 years for me that I don't know the difference anymore.
You fucking millennials.
Yeah.
Both of you. where it's just like you want to have everything. Here's the thing. I like Weird Al.
Of course.
It cost me a lot to like Weird Al. When I was a kid and I was like, I like Weird Al, that was uncool and weird. But you guys could be like, haha, I love Weird Al. He's so bad, but he's good. But he's mad. I love him. I hate him. And you can like dance on this line that as a Gen Xer, I didn't get to dance on this line.
I haven't bullied for dancing to Dare to Be Stupid?
Yes, Mumkey Jones.
I can't imagine such a cruel world.
You mean Dare to Be Stupid, song that Weird Al Yankovic co-wrote with Mark Mothersbaugh from Devo, the song that was on the soundtrack to the Transformers movie? Are you asking me whether or not Dare to Be Stupid might be cause for mockery? Yes, it's cause for mockery!
Put all your eggs in one basket. You better count your chickens before they hatch. You better sell some wine before it's time. You better find yourself an itch to scratch. You better...
My favorite anime, Weird Al.
Out of a molehill, you better ask a volunteer. Weird Al's great. My first concert was a Weird Al concert. So if that's the most millennial thing you've ever heard, then there you go.
It's not, though. Oh. Because for you guys, it was... what I'm saying is it was okay to like Weird Al for you.
Yeah, that's a millennial thing.
That was after I had the autism beat out of me, so I'm sorry I didn't.
Who beat you?
All right, cheerleader, calm down.
Who beat me? It was a bunch of other people. I did some bad shit in high school.
What did you do in high school? Oh, my God.
Just became the bully. Wow. But, see, like, more normally when you get bullied in middle school, then you learn and you're, like, nicer to other people. I went the exact opposite direction.
What?
You must have changed a lot in the last 2 years.
My cuntiness is now actually in remission. So
thank goodness.
I've become better. I've become significantly
better. I can't imagine
better.
An anime fan being a cunt, especially online.
Yeah, exactly.
Very civil and kind.
You kind of gotta.
You've literally told me about times that you've made Japanese girls cry on Reddit.
I've made American girls cry as well.
How dare you?
Tell us a little bit more about that.
One time when I was in high school, you know what senior week is?
Yes.
Me and my pals planned a trip senior week to go to the beach and intentionally excluded this one girl that we thought was a bitch. And she didn't find out until 2 days before the trip, and her mom called all of our moms and yelled at us, "I'm so sorry, Danielle."
Danielle, I know you're watching at home.
Danielle, I'm really sorry.
You better accept that apology.
Listen,
Danielle.
I was a big fucking cunt. This is a day of apologies for me.
No.
Jordan,
I'm
sorry.
I'm taking the other side of this. Danielle, if you weren't such a flaming bitch, Sriracha would have invited you to senior skip day.
She wasn't a bitch. She was just really annoying.
What was so annoying about her? Did you talk about anime constantly, like the two of you goofballs?
No, like I said, that was after I had the autism beat out of me.
Okay.
She was just annoying.
I'm going to move us on right the fuck now. Because you're
Dude,
both,
I'm sorry.
You're both making me uncomfortable. Now, you're both anime fans. Now, I've asked you each to bring in who your waifu is. For those who don't know, someone's waifu means their weirdo cartoon wife, the anime character that they feel emotionally connected to, so emotionally connected to that they make them their cartoon wife. Now, a lot of people talk about this stuff in an ironic context, like, ha ha ha, he's my waifu, she's my waifu.
Nope.
That's what I'm saying. Underneath this thick layer of detachment and irony is a very real love for these cartoons.
It's the peanut in the peanut M&M.
And I've asked both of these people to tell me who their waifus are. And I'm gonna try to judge which of their waifus is just a good partner. I'm gonna try to judge which of their waifus is best. And I suppose by best, I mean least worst. Mumkey, would you care to start?
Well, you could say this is a bit of a waifu war, couldn't you? Yeah, that's the name of the show. Guys, I don't know what shitty fucking waifu you're bringing in, but I'm about to win this with the best waifu of all time. There's a little anime I like to call Death Note, featuring the ultimate waifu, a character named Misa Amane. Now, Asterios, Misa Amane, first of all, is a famous pop star, famous across all of Japan.
It's her! I'm like your biggest fan!
What is this?
But, and I have to assume, when you go into the world of waifus, that the character who is your waifu loves you with the same amount of compassion and affection that she loves the characters in the show. Is that fair to say?
Sure.
Because Misa Amane,
I mean, we are talking about a weird fictional cartoon where people put their names in a book and then they die.
Right, right.
I've heard of this Death Note thing.
Yeah.
My little brother was like, "You gotta watch Death Note." I was like, "What's Death Note about?"
Yeah,
they're
right.
Like, "You write down a name in a book and then the person dies." And I was like, "This sounds dumb." But everybody loves Death Note!
If you want to get into Death Note, Netflix just made a live-action American version of it, and it's very good.
Are you kidding me?
You put my name in the book, I got mad at him.
Are you kidding
me? You loved me, I thought you wouldn't take the book!
It did not ruin the anime at all. It's just amazing and perfect in every way. And I highly recommend it. I would say don't even watch the anime, just watch the American live-action film. Because it's just perfect.
What the fuck?
Okay.
It's just perfect.
Tell me about why this girl's so great.
Misa Amane. The plot with Misa Amane, folks at home, is that she is incredibly smitten and in love with the main character of Death Note, Light Yagami. So here's why Misa Amane's in love with Light Yagami, because her parents were killed by this guy. Light, in all his infinite godly wisdom, also known as Kira, kills the guy who killed Misa's parents, making Misa in love with Light, and she is so smitten, so in love with him. You got this beautiful, famous, talented pop star who is head over heels in love with you, will do whatever you want, but also you know, she's a little bit difficult. It makes it a bit of a challenge to be with her, which I think is important for any, you know, significant other. It can't be too easy. You can't be dating your maid. Okay? You got to have somebody who is a complex character.
Is that like
an
anime saying, you can't be dating your maid?
I have no idea. No.
Okay, I'm just double checking.
He's just speaking words.
I'm speaking words, and I'm speaking from the heart. And Misa Amane got my heart from the first time I saw her.
It's only been 4 minutes since you last went to the bathroom. I'm afraid you'll have to hold it.
You have to. It's the only time you'll untie me and let me move. Plus, you'd be able to watch. Isn't that what you want? Isn't it? You pervert!
And I'll go into it deeper, but I want to hear what shitty-ass waifu you brought in.
Hey,
well,
kids!
Wait a minute. Before you guys start going at each other like cats and dogs...
Oh, I'm going to go at him.
Let me point out that A, you're both in love with cartoons and you're both stupid. But B...
Next question.
Okay. Well, I do like the idea of dating a celebrity.
Celebrity who is in love with you. Can you imagine if Christina Aguilera said, I want some of that Asterios dick?
Let's not go that far. But you could maybe be a friend of mine. Would that be okay?
I literally can't. That, my mind can't possibly contain the thought that a popular celebrity singer would like me. So, wow.
That's Misa Amane for you. Misa, as she likes to be called.
Okay, Misa is in love with the main character because the main character... murdered her parents' murderer.
It's the purest kind of love.
Oh my god, I'm just... You know what? That's pretty hot.
Yeah.
If my parents got murdered and some chick came up to you and was like, hey, I avenged your parents' deaths. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go sing in a concert for thousands of people, I'd be like, I like you a lot.
Yeah.
So, Mumkey... Right off the bat, this lady sounds cool.
Yeah.
I'm just putting that out there.
And she's smoking hot. Smoking hot.
Can you describe her physically?
No way! Somebody just touched my butt!
No.
Okay. You know what? Mumkey Jones gets a lot of credit because he's only described her in non-gross sexual terms. This whole time he's been talking about this girl, he hasn't mentioned... her cup size? No. Unlike our last guest, which seemed obsessed with cup size. I don't know what color this girl's hair is. I don't know. But she seems cool.
You have to be hot to be a pop star.
Yeah, you do.
And I haven't seen Death Note in 3 years, so I don't remember what she looks like.
That's totally fine.
I know her personality because I'm not shallow like, you know, certain srirachas.
Yeah, like Sriracha over here was only interested in the physical.
Am I allowed to make my retort now?
Okay, but look. Just putting this out there, Mumkey. I'm picking up what you're laying down, and I like what you're saying. Sriracha, let me hear about your waifu.
Hey, kids, one question quiz. Why is Misa still alive? The answer is because her death god had to actually kill herself because Misa is dumb as a goddamn stump. She somehow managed to get herself caught as Kira... What is it, twice, Mumkey?
Now, here's the thing. Just real quick. I don't understand a thing she said, but it sounds like she's got your number. I agree with her based on tone and confidence alone.
The only reason Misa didn't have to bite through her tongue and drown in her own blood was because Light swooped in to save her.
Okay, time out for a second. Your argument seems to be that Misa Amane is stupid.
Yes.
Who wants to date a woman who's smarter than you?
Wait a minute. If a girl was smarter than me, it would intimidate me and
it
would make my
pee-pee
feel small.
Your pee-pee would be tiny.
What I'm looking for is a girl who I can be like, they're there. You know, I'm looking for a girl who I can kind of have a domineering affect over.
A girl who sees you literally as a god and respects everything you say, listens to every piece of advice you give. You don't want a woman who's thinking for herself.
I don't want a woman who's going to trade half of her lifespan.
She does it twice. She trades half of her lifespan twice because she loves you so much. Can you think of a woman who loves you so much that she would cut her lifespan down
by
a four?
She's going to die in 5 years.
Wait a minute. Is this girl going to die at age 24? Because if yes. Not a great waifu. I'm in this for the long haul, Mumkey Jones.
Let me tell you about my waifu.
Yeah, let's
Yo
hear it.
Watanabe.
Who?
Yo Watanabe. Yo Watanabe from Love Live Sunshine. Also a pop star.
Okay.
Does not have to cut her life in half twice because she's so fucking stupid. She manages to get caught in Japan out of everyone. They are able to actually track her down, and Light has to save her ass toy. Let me ask you a question, Mumkey. Okay. Do you even lift, bro?
That's a tough one.
Exactly. Yo Watanabe is her hobby is weightlifting.
What?
Not only
You want to have a waifu who's stronger and smarter than you? I don't think
Hell
so.
Hell yeah, I do.
Wait a minute. No. Now I'm seeing. Okay, I don't want a girl who's smarter than me.
No.
I don't want a girl who's stronger than me.
No.
But a girl who's stronger and smarter than me, that might make me a better person. And I'm telling you right now, I need to become a better person, Mumkey Jones. I am as shallow as a baby's grave. I like this girl. Continue.
Her hobbies include singing, dancing, and sailing. She sails a boat.
Can I just like hang out on her boat and like drink margaritas?
Fuck yeah, you can. Fuck yeah, you can.
Wait a minute, Mumkey Jones. I like this girl.
She's a pop star. She's in the popular idol group Aqua. And she was number one on a lot of popularity polls a while ago.
Now, wait a minute. This girl sounds like she's a girl from that weird game you play.
Exactly.
Can you plug your game name?
Here's my game name at the bottom of the screen.
Okay, she plays this game where like she pushes buttons and then the buttons make girls sing.
Yeah, and they tell you they love you.
Wait, do they really?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Tell me more about this game real quick.
You collect the cards and then you have to, when you increase your bond with them enough, then you get to go on a date with them.
Are you serious?
I'm dead fucking serious.
You get to date the girls you make sing?
Yes. What's the question?
How
here?
Many dates have you been on with this girl you're talking about?
Oh, over 10.
Really?
Yeah.
Do these dates ever end, like, with you guys going home together? Like,
no, of course not.
I don't know.
Cutesy little, I hope you're going to come to our show later. Yeah, no, it's never anything explicit.
But you get backstage passes to go see Aqua.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, you get backstage passes. All right.
This girl's a weightlifter, Mumkey Jones. Now, look, it's a little intimidating when girls have big arms. I agree.
Yeah.
It makes my pee-pee feel small. And when they're smart, it makes my pee-pee feel small. In fact, when they have confidence that's not directly derived from my compliment towards them, it makes my pee-pee feel small.
Yeah.
Like, if they make more money than me, it makes my pee-pee feel small.
Yeah.
Like, what I'm looking for in real life is, like, a girl who I can, like, completely override. You know, like, a girl who's sort of, like, secondary to me. Like, a sidekick.
Sure.
Is the girl you're pitching me a sidekick or a main character?
Well, Serancho, I hate to ruin your buzz here.
Oh, no.
But the whole point of a waifu is somebody who you are madly in love with. If this... You know, whatever her name is. Yo? Is that her name?
Yeah.
If Yo is such a famous pop star, Serancho, let's hear one of her songs.
Yes. Let's hear one of her songs.
Because one would assume if you can't, you know, recite one of her songs, maybe she's not such a good waifu after all.
Exactly. If my waifu was Madonna, I could be like, just like a prayer, I want to take you there.
Well,
in
can
the
you top from...
Hour. I'm feeling your power, just like a dream. You know the one for me. Like a bird. But can you sing any of your pop star waifu songs?
Of course I can. I know her whole discography.
Well, then sing one right now, Serancho.
Well, she's in the idol group Aqua, and then she's also in a subunit called Sairon.
Sing a goddamn song now or you lose.
Are you
loser?
No, fucking, this is your waifu. Sing for your waifu.
Dude, I can't sing. You don't want me to sing on this.
That does not sound like a real waifu if she can't sing. Oh, okay.
Why don't your waifu's also a pop star? Why don't you name one song that
she... Actually, before he does, Mumkey Jones wouldn't have brought up the idea of singing a song if he couldn't sing one.
Yeah, so why don't you go ahead?
Honestly, this is on you. You gotta sing your heart out. Because I'm not kidding, Monkey's about to blow you out of the water.
He is.
Sing the song and sing it good. Go!
You know what? I'm just going to fold. And I'm going to see his song. Let's hear it.
Well, I guess you don't really love your cartoon wife.
I love her so much that I don't want to see her on stage prancing around in those sexualized little outfits because I know she's a pure girl.
No, who wants a pure waifu, first of all?
No waiting. I like what you just said. She's trying to protect honor of her waifu where you're going to fucking cart your waifu out like yesterday's tart?
Exactly, because you brought it up.
What
You're
are you,
sing.
Fucking 13? You want a virgin, you sick fuck? I want a woman who's experienced and sexualized and proud of her sexuality and is not afraid to flaunt it on stage in front of millions of people.
Now Mumkey Jones has got my attention. If you've ever been with a virgin, it's not great.
No.
But if you've been with a girl who, like, she knows what she's doing.
She knows what she's doing.
Like, oh, this is pretty good.
Yeah. I want a girl that can lift me up.
That's pretty good, too. Okay.
That's Mumkey, all I care about.
Would you care to sing?
What sexual position requires the woman to hold you up? Yeah.
Well, clearly, you're not very creative.
I've never been with a bodybuilder before, actually.
Just hold this kind of like this.
Okay.
All right. May I hear one of your songs?
Yes. Misa Amane, in a very famous scene of Death Note, I'm not going to spoil too much, but in a scene where Light kills a very important character, Misa sings a song that goes... One by one, something.
This is right before she kills herself, right?
No, she doesn't die in Death Note.
No, she in the anime, she does.
No, she doesn't.
She jumps off a building.
No, she doesn't die.
She jumps off a building.
Why?
That does not happen in the anime. That must be a manga exclusive.
Are you ready? Nope, here we go.
Okay,
yeah, that's a screenshot of the song I was just singing.
Sriracha is pulling up.
That's interesting that you know the song she sings, but not that she jumps off a building while she's
singing.
There's
no way she dies in that scene.
If I may, I'm the ultimate judge here.
Yeah, give that to Stereos. Gonna...
Okay, I'm looking at a blonde girl on... Oh, sorry, I'll buy you a new iPhone. I'm looking at a...
Just fucking got that.
Okay, hold on. It's,
God damn it, I'm going to kill you.
You know what?
I'm gonna kill you. You're gonna be as dead as Moses.
Here's the song. Here's the song I was singing.
Okay, I'm seeing a girl on a bridge. Whenever there's a Japanese girl on a bridge, it's always a bad thing. She's got blonde hair. She seems to be walking with purpose. I'm seeing a shot of everyone else in black and white, but she's in full color.
She's singing a song about death.
Okay.
She's an ultimate waifu.
Okay, I'm seeing somebody writing a name in a book. Uh-oh. Did this dude kill his
waifu? No. Her lover is dead.
No, he's...
No reason for her to live.
No, okay, her lover is not dead. Kira is still alive.
She's wearing big platform shoes like Light a fucking Hot Topic goth.
Yeah, Sun she's a Hot Topic goth. That's like the ultimate waifu.
Okay, I do like that because Hot Topic goths, like, they're real loose. Okay, hold on. The sun is going down.
I do not see a suicide attempt. Nope, the video ended, no suicide.
We're going to look on Wikipedia and see if
honestly, I don't care how long it takes. I want to know whether or not this character's dead or alive.
Listen, Asterios.
Uh-huh, Mumkey.
I don't want to spoil life for you, but everybody dies.
Wait a minute.
You got to enjoy your waifu while she's alive. And while she's alive, she's the ultimate waifu.
And... if she dies at age 24, then she's dying when she's literally the hottest.
Oh, yeah. You don't have to watch her become an old, disgusting, wrinkly woman. You get to enjoy her in her prime, and you never have to
become old and wrinkly because they're waifus.
I would rather my girlfriend be dead than be old.
Your girlfriend is dead, so that's good.
If she's old,
waifu is dead.
Yes. Yeah. She's dead as a goddamn doornail.
Okay. Find out what's going on with this character.
She's dead. That's it.
Let me see her Wikia. Profile. These fucking cartoons have a goddamn... There's some goddamn anime Wikipedia thing where all these fucking people put in all this shit about these goddamn anime characters and you read it and you're just like, oh, I feel bad for anyone. Anyone who contributed to this. Alright. While Serancha is finding this out, and I forget why we're looking this up and I forget whether or not I care. I have to say, the fact that you're willing to sing for your waifu...
Oh, of course.
...makes me like this girl a lot.
I've never heard of her waifu, and I already forgot who she is, because she's so forgettable. But she... You know, she's been talking so much shit about my waifu. Apparently, you can remember who she is. I don't even know who she's talking about over there.
Interesting. Rebuttal?
Of course I remember. Are you saying that I don't remember my waifu?
I'm saying I don't remember your waifu, but you remember mine. I think mine's, you know.
Well, yeah, because I knew who your waifu was coming in. Because
nobody
mine
knows who yours is.
20 years
old. What kind
old?
Of pop star is unrecognizable?
I don't know. What kind of pop star is 20 years old and in the ground?
Every single
dead?
One.
Oh, my God.
All of them.
Wait. There's only one. Selena. My favorite. If I could have any wife, it would probably be Selena.
Rip.
Rip-a-roni.
Rip in peace.
Rip-a-roni. Let me see this Death Note girl's Wikipedia page.
All right.
I want to see how she dies. Because here's the thing. She dies in a real hot way, like in a sex contest. That's good for you. But
oh, good.
We just saw her last...
No, we didn't. We saw her singing on a
although
bridge.
It is not shown, it is theorized that she committed suicide following Light's death.
Theorized. Okay, we're not some fucking Einstein
okay, well,
here.
You know
we're not making theories.
You know whose wife was definitely alive? Mine.
At the end of the series, shortly after Light's death, Misa is seen standing on the ledge of a tall building.
Oh, baby!
Although it's not shown, it is theorized that she committed suicide following Light's death. Well, let me put this out there, Mumkey Jones, and I honestly have no dog in this fight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm seeing a girl in big, tall shoes standing at the edge of a building in a series called Death Note, singing a sad song to herself. Also, she's Japanese.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's dead.
All waifus are Japanese, first of all. And second of all, she doesn't commit suicide until Light is dead. In this scenario, I am placing myself in the role of Light because she's in love with Light. So upon your death, your waifu commits suicide because she's so fucking sad? That's the hottest, most romantic thing imaginable.
She follows you to heaven so she could give you blowjobs up there.
Exactly.
Wait a minute.
What he's conveniently forgetting to mention is that Misa is so stupid that she got Light killed.
Wow.
And she will get you killed.
It's sad when Mumkey Jones is the most feminist person at the table. You're just going to write a woman off as being stupid.
I'm going to write Misa off because she's dumb as a goddamn rock.
Successful pop star. She became Kira number two. She made a death god fall in love with
her.
Yeah,
she became Kira number two by cutting her lifespan in half twice.
You gotta get the Shinigami eyes somehow.
You gotta get them twice? Why did she do it the second time?
If Kira was intelligent, he would have done it. The reason why Kira lost to L or to N is because he did not get the Shinigami
the
eyes.
The only reason... Okay, first of all, Kira did not lose to L. L dies.
He lost to N, which was L's successor. So
yeah,
in a way, he lost to L.
The only reason he even talks to Misa is because she's got the eyes.
Because he's in love with her.
He's not in love with her.
I think if you're relying on somebody to keep yourself alive,
no,
that might
like
be a little bit of love.
No, like it could not nip two shits about me.
Well, if I'm in self-inserting myself as Light,
well,
Light
maybe.
Is in love with Kira, or with Misa.
Listen, you're just projecting your fantasies onto...
That's the whole point of waifus, is to project fantasies. Am I right, Asterios?
It seems like it.
It seems like
okay, I'm hearing a lot about this Death Note girl.
Yeah.
I want to hear a little more
about...
Yeah,
let's hear about this fucking yo bitch.
Yeah, what do you want to talk about? She's perfect in every way.
Okay, I like that she's a weightlifter.
Yeah.
I used to date an MMA girl. Oh my god, she was so strong. She could literally, like, bench press me above her.
There's one scene where someone comes up behind Yo and scares her by tapping on her shoulder, and she grabs her by the arm and flings her over her. That's how strong she is. And she could incorporate that into the bedroom.
Okay, I do like that a lot. Yo is a good singer. I like that.
Fuck yeah, she is.
Can you walk me through, like, a date with me and Yo? Like, what would we do on a date?
First of all, she's super happy all the time. So she is going to be fucking thrilled
obnoxious.
To see you.
Obnoxious. I need somebody with multiple emotions.
Oh, yeah,
here.
Like,
no,
Misa's
no,
not obnoxious.
No.
Misa only has one personality, and it's...
Her personality is that she's in love with you. Oh
my
heaven
gosh.
Heaven forbid.
She's got two settings of her personalities, and it's super excited and then commits suicide.
No, super excited and commits mass genocide on your behalf. She's a hero.
Wait.
Misa kills a lot of people in Death Note.
A lot of people.
How?
Because she gets the second Death Note and she pretends to be Kira to protect Light. She'll
what does she write down in the book? Like, all criminals must die?
Yes. Yeah, she'll kill criminals to protect you. Because she loves you so much. That's a top-tier waifu.
Wait a minute. This waifu has a book where when she writes names down, the people die.
Yeah, that's the premises of Death Note.
She kills thousands of people in Death Note.
Wait. I like this. Yeah. Are the people she kills bad? Yes or no, Serac?
Yes.
I mean, debatable. Doesn't she also kill the wife of that police officer?
That's
just trying to, like, find out what happened to her husband.
No, that was episode 5. Misa wasn't even in the show then.
Oh, really?
White killed her.
And so there is in love with an asshole.
Wait, she's in love with a crazy murderer that kills some cop's poor wife?
Yes, for no other reason than she was just trying to find out what happened to her husband.
There is no moral ambiguity in Death Note. The whole point of the show is that Kira does nothing wrong and that he's the hero of the show. So Misa being in love with Kira is just a highlight.
So your wife is in love with the psychopath.
Which is me. Because I self-insert as Kira, so Misa is in love with me. And
okay, no questions
there. She will commit mass genocide on my behalf. What romantic gesture will your wife
do? Well, my wife is not a psycho.
Boring. So
my wife will love you in the traditional way.
I'm putting this out there. Her wife who seems like a lot less trouble. Because
yeah, and you can leave her alone for more than 5 minutes and she won't kill herself.
Okay, A, there's that.
She doesn't kill herself until the man she loves is already dead, so it's not even going to affect me.
Yeah, but she gets herself into situations where she would have been killed if it were not other people.
On your behalf. I want a woman who will have my back no matter what, no matter how much genocide I've committed. She's going to have my back and protect me, and that's exactly what Misa does.
Well, seriously, the question we've got to ask is how much genocide do you want to commit?
Plenty of genocide!
Here's the interesting thing. None of this seems performative. Like, I'm not kidding. These two people are, like, getting real heated about these cartoons.
Misa did nothing wrong.
Okay, everybody start drinking some more. I really like being on this Waifu Wars show.
Do you think this is a joke? This is not a joke.
Because to me it is. To you guys it's clearly not.
No.
Now I'm going to put this out there. Your waifu seems like a lot less of a hassle. I don't know that I want to be dating a girl who has a book where, like, if I forget her birthday...
You dead, motherfucker.
She'll, like, write my name down in the book and I'll die.
She would never do that because she's madly in love with you and only kills people when you tell her to.
You would need to become her idol, though. That's a lot of work.
That's the whole point of the waifu, is that I'm self-inserting as the character she's in love with. That's the whole point of a waifu, is you assume she loves you as much as the characters.
Are you ready to commit genocide?
I've been ready to commit genocide and die since I was 12 years old.
You heard it here first, kids.
Okay, I like that this chick is fit.
Yeah.
I like that she doesn't have a murder book.
Boring.
I like that she is in a pop group. What color is your hair?
Gray.
Gray? What is she, fucking 70 years old? Misa has the blonde hair of a woman in her youth.
You think that's real?
Of course
she's
real.
Japanese.
Are you telling me blonde is not a natural Japanese hair color?
I'm making a guess and saying she's dying.
I don't think so.
Okay, so you've got...
Just say my waifu wins.
So, no, I'm still... If I could, I would. I am still trying to figure this out. Everything I'm hearing about your girl sounds hot. She's got like a sexy body. She takes care of herself. Gray hair, honestly, is this like weird millennial thing where like these millennial girls dye their hair gray?
Yeah, it's dyed.
And
it's not like it's naturally
they do
gray.
It to it's weird, but sometimes I've seen like super young hot girls with gray hair and I'm kind of like, okay, that's like really affected, but at the same time it's real hot. What would it take for your girl to kill herself?
Oh. Well, she's never been suicidally depressed, I don't think.
Boring.
Listen, I want to be the suicidally depressed one in the relationship. I'm looking for a girl to take care of me. Take me to her concerts and sing songs to me. Get me to the fucking gym for once in my goddamn life.
Oh, she's going to do that. And she's not even going to... She's going to make workout fun.
This girl sounds cool, man.
Every girl I've ever loved has been... depressed and suicidal. And okay. And if you can't get into that, then don't even try.
Wait a minute.
What I think it would take for her to kill herself is she would have to, her whole pop group would have to vote her out.
Oh, how pathetic. Where my wife Wait, would commit would suicide because the man she's in love with, me, is already dead. I want her to be more dedicated to me than some fucking pop
Excuse
group.
Me, let me tell you, Misa was ready to die. Like, if Light did not save her, she was ready to bite through her tongue
because
and
she
her
loved
blood.
Light so much, and if she couldn't
Light
be
with Light
was
not dead,
him.
She just thought she was being an inconvenience to this.
You guys keep mentioning bite through tongue.
So at one point, does Light tell her to kill herself, or...
No.
She gets the idea to kill herself somehow. And
who would have thought a Japanese girl might get the idea to kill herself?
Yeah, I don't know
where it could possibly come from.
But she's tied up and she can't. She's like blindfolded. So the only way she could think of, she's like, she goes to try to bite through her tongue and bleed in her own blood. And somebody's like, oh, she's going to drain her own blood. So they have to run in and like stick a towel in her mouth.
That really happens?
It's the product of true love, Asterios. Yeah, if you want true love, you go with my wife.
He doesn't
if want
to
If you want
it,
some
yeah,
shallow pop star bitch, you go with that
shallow
wife.
Shallow pop star bitch.
Now, wait a minute.
Also yours.
Wait a minute.
Would your wife who commit suicide on your behalf? Because yes. That's true love to me. No,
I think
she
mine
wouldn't.
Would.
You said yours would only commit suicide if her pop group broke up.
You did say that.
Because her pop group is her love right now, until she meets me.
Okay, listen. Bullshit. I'm going to put this out there, though. Mumkey Jones' wife, who sounds like she's like super obsessed with me.
She thinks you're a god.
And as a result, kind of like whatever I want in the bedroom seems like it would kind of be on the table.
Of course.
Yeah.
Like, she'll do whatever you want.
You know what I'm saying? It's like if this girl is like willing to like bite off her tongue and drain her blood through her tongue to kill herself, I think she might be into like some of the gross stuff I'm into.
Oh, game. She'll do whatever you want.
And I'm just saying, like, this sounds like a pretty good girl. Just
but whereas the girl who respects her body so much that she works out every day, she's probably not going to let you, you know, get her face all.
Hey. We don't need to get specific. Hey. Let's just be very general.
I was about to say the word nut, and I censored myself.
Goodbye, Ad Rev.
See you later, YouTube Ad Revenue.
Bye.
Glad I spent hundreds of dollars renting these cameras. Okay. Your girl.
Barry, keep that in.
Your girl.
The fuck is Barry?
Barry's our editor. Your girl. Okay. This girl thinks I'm a god?
Yes, she respects you as a god and she wants to do whatever you say.
This girl thinks I'm a god and it's like, look, I understand that doesn't make a great long-term partnership, but like for a year or two? Sounds pretty hot. I'm just
Let me ask you this question.
Sure.
Have you ever stuck your dick in crazy? Yes or no?
Yes.
Did it work out in a long term?
No, but I
Exact no. There you go.
But you didn't let me finish. But I have a lot of really good memories of it, where it's just like, when I've stuck my dick in crazy, has it worked out? Of course not, but some of these crazy girls are just
Have
like,
I stuck my dick in crazy? Yes. Did it work out? No, of course not. That's the quote I want you to remember when you're choosing your
memories
waifu.
Are much more valuable than long-term
waifus
commitment.
Are forever,
no,
though.
Wait a minute. Waifus are forever. I'm not looking for like a one... night stand with a cartoon. I am looking for a cartoon wife.
Exactly. If you're going to be a normie that changes their waifu every 3 months, then go ahead, stick your dick in crazy.
Sriracha's actually bringing up a really good point. It's like, your girl sounds like I could have maybe the best weekend of my life with. Your girl sounds like the kind of person who'd be a good long-term partner.
Exactly.
And that's what I'm looking for ultimately in a waifu. Wait, Monkey... You're an anime expert. Tell me I'm wrong.
I think your decision has to come down to a choice between the best weekend of your life or a lifetime of mundanity. What do you choose?
A best weekend of genocide of your life.
The best genocide weekend of your life or a lifetime
of
mundanity.
Or a lifetime of happiness.
A lifetime of an average boring woman who does not treat you like a god.
Wait a minute. This girl doesn't sound average and boring. She's a bodybuilder slash pop star.
A woman who's...
She's got cool gray
hair. Oh, no. Your argument is breaking down.
No. If she's better than you, then she's below average. The perfect woman is somebody who's worse than you in every way and looks up to you as a god.
You know what? If I was in my 20s, I'd agree with you. But Mumkey Jones, I've been through some shit. And let me tell you, I'm looking for a girl who's going to make me a better person.
Fuck.
Because absolutely nothing else will. Mumkey Jones, let me tell you something right now. I'm a huge scumbag. But I'm looking for a girl who's like nice and cool, who can like maybe help me stop being such a weirdo scumbag. Sriracha, what's the name of your waifu?
Yo, Watanabe.
Okay, A. That's maybe the most stereotypical Japanese
it
name I've
sucks.
Ever heard. Yo Watanabe.
And it's spelled Y-O-U.
What's your waifu's name?
Misa Amane.
Misa Amane. Better name. Better lay. Worst waifu. I gotta go with Yo Watanabe.
Fucking
congratulations!
God damn it!
Sriracha, you have won the Waifu Wars!
Thank you.
Sriracha. I want you to tell me about the perfect date with me and Yo Watanabe.
Okay,
and I'm just
going
to like self-insert myself.
Well, first, she shows up to your doorstep at a reasonable hour.
7 o'clock.
No.
What?
Wait, at night?
Yes.
This is a day date.
What?
It's a Sunday.
But I have to go to work. Okay, it's a Sunday.
It's a Sunday.
Okay. 2 p.m.
Wrong, 10 a.m.
I'm not up at 10 a.m.
Well, you are now because she's improving your life.
Wait a minute, you're right. If I was up at 10 a.m., I could maybe get some shit done.
Right.
Continue.
She shows up at your door at 10 a.m. You wake up now at 9 a.m. because after dating her for so long, you wake up and go to the gym.
That's what we do?
Right. You're like 4 months into dating.
Okay.
She shows up and she's got a big basket there. And you say, whoa, yo, what are you doing with that? She said, we're going to go have a picnic.
She made the food?
Of course she did.
I don't know. Wow.
Because she loves you that much.
I love her too.
So you take her out to the wharf where her boat is. She can sail a sailboat by herself.
Oh my God. My dad would love it if I knew how to sail.
Yeah, she sails all the way out and you guys enjoy a picnic on the boat in the middle of the wharf.
Can
Japan,
we have,
somewhere.
Can we have sex on the boat?
I don't know if she's underage.
What?